Comparison between electric and magnetic monopole and dipoles. So in this we compare the electric and magnetic monopoles and dipoles. Monopoles means single pole. In case of electrostatic, there is a monopole because in this we consider a point charge. A point charge is a single charge and it acts as a monopole. So, in case of electrostatic, we consider point charge, so there is a monopole, that is a Q. And due to this Q, there is electric field at any point P, and we can also determine the potential. So, in case of electrostatic, the monopole has a potential that is equals to Q upon 4 pi epsilon naught R, and electric field intensity E vector equals to Q upon 4 pi epsilon naught R square in the direction of unit vector R. But in case of magnetostatics, there is no monopole because the magnetic charge cannot be isolated. If there is a north pole, there is also a south pole. So, we cannot isolate a magnetic charge. So, there is no monopole. So, the magnetic charge, that is Q suffix M, is not exist. So, there is no monopole. Now, the dipole. In case of electrostatic, there is a dipole, that is a system in which there are two point charge which having a magnitude, same magnitude but opposite sign. So, in electrostatic, there is an electric dipole which consists of plus Q and minus Q, and these two charges are separated by a small distance d. Due to this dipole, we can determine the potential and electric field intensity at some point P. And in case of dipole, we consider a spherical coordinate system. So, at point P, we can determine potential V and electric field intensity E. The potential V in case of electric dipole is given by Q into d cos theta upon 4 pi epsilon naught R square. Q into d is called a electric dipole denoted by small p. The formula is P cos theta upon 4 pi epsilon naught R square. This can also be written in terms of dot product, that is P vector dot unit vector R upon 4 pi epsilon naught R square. So, this is a electric potential, that is a scalar one, and the electric field intensity is equals to QD upon 4 pi epsilon naught R cube within bracket 2 cos theta unit vector R plus sin theta unit vector theta. And in case of magnetostatics, the dipole is a small current loop. The small current loop behave as a magnetic dipole. As we see from the top view, the current is flowing in anticlockwise direction. So, it behave as a north pole, and as we see from the bottom view, the current is flowing in a clockwise direction and it behave as a south pole. So, a small current loop is behave as a magnetic dipole, and due to this small current loop, we can determine the magnetic vector potential, that is A vector, and magnetic flux density B vector. This small current loop behaves as a magnetic dipole. So, this is equivalent to magnetic charge QM and minus QM separated by small distance D. If there is a plus QM, there is also minus QM. So, with the help of magnetic dipole, we can determine the magnetic vector potential A vector, which is given by mu naught m sin theta unit vector phi upon 4 pi r square. And it is also written as mu naught m vector cross unit vector r upon 4 pi r square. And the magnetic flux density B vector is equals to mu naught m upon 4 pi r cube within bracket 2 cos theta unit vector r plus sin theta unit vector theta. So, this is a comparison between electric and magnetic monopoles and dipoles. We can relate it also. In case of electric dipole, we consider a scalar potential, and in case of magnetic dipole, we consider a magnetic vector potential, that is A vector. That is due to the current density G vector. Next is the field lines. As we see that in electric dipole, it consists of two point charges separated by a small distance, and the electric flux lines or field lines is originate from positive charge and terminate to the negative charge. So, the electric dipole has a field lines as shown in figure that is originate from positive charge and terminate to the negative charge. And this electric dipole has a dipole moment that is given by small p vector, that is equals to q into d vector. In magnetostatics, there are two types of magnetic dipole. One is a small current loop and second is a bar magnet. As we know that the bar magnet is a permanent magnet in which there are two permanent poles, north pole and south pole. So it behaves as a magnetic dipole. And the second magnetic dipole is a small current loop. Here a current is flowing in a small loop, so it behaves as a magnetic dipole. And this small current loop having a magnetic dipole moment, that is small m vector, is equals to I into S vector, where I is the current flowing in a small loop and S is the area of this loop. While in case of bar magnet, the magnetic dipole moment is denoted by m vector and it is equals to qm into L vector, where qm is called a magnetic charge. Since in case of magnetic dipole, the two charge, that is a magnetic charge having positive and negative sign, always exist in pair. Since we cannot isolate a magnetic charge, we can isolate a electric charge, but we cannot isolate a magnetic charge. So there is no monopole in case of magnetic dipole, and the magnetic dipole moment for a bar magnet is equals to q suffix m into L vector, where L vector is directed from south pole to north pole. As we see that the field lines in case of bar magnet originate from north pole and terminate to the south pole, and inside this magnet the field lines are from south pole to north pole. That's why we take a L vector from south pole to north pole. Now we talk about the magnetic torque due to this magnetic dipole. As we know that the magnetic torque is denoted by T vector and it is equals to R vector cross F vector. In this, the R is called a momentum arm and F is the force on momentum arm, and it behaves as a couple of force. So The moment arm in case of bar magnet, that is a width. Width, if we consider a width of this magnet is W, and the force is equals to vector B cross ideal vector. So the formula becomes W into B I into L sine alpha. Here we take a cross product, so in case of cross product we get a sine alpha. And here length into width is called area, that is denoted by S. So from here the torque is equals to I into S B sine alpha. We take I into S as a momentum. So the I into S is momentum, that is denoted by small m. So the torque become m into B sine alpha. And this formula, that is m into b sine alpha, can be written in a cross product form. That is, torque T vector is equals to m vector cross b vector, where m vector is called a magnetic dipole moment and b vector is called a magnetic flux density. So this formula of the torque can be used for bar magnet as well as for current loop. Now we place a bar magnet in the external magnetic field such that the bar magnet whose L vector makes an angle 90 degree with respect to B vector, that is here the angle alpha is 90 degree. By putting the value of small m vector, that is q suffix m into L vector, we get a torque T vector is equals to q suffix m L vector cross B vector. So here we determine the cross product of L vector and B vector. Since the L vector and B vector having an angle of 90 degree, so the cross product of these two vectors having a value that is torque T equals to Qm L into B, because sine alpha, that is sine 90 degree, is equals to 1. So we get a torque is equals to Q suffix M L into B. Now we consider a current loop. We place a current loop such that its normal direction makes an angle of 90 degree with respect to B vector, and we put the value of M vector, small m vector, that is a magnetic dipole moment, is equals to I into S vector. So the torque, magnetic torque T vector, is equals to I into S vector cross B vector. And since the S vector is the area and its direction is normal, and this normal unit vector makes an angle of 90 degree, so the sine 90 degree is again 1, and we get the magnetic torque T vector is equals to I S into B. So from here we conclude that Q suffix M L into B is equals to I into S into B. Here B is cancelled and we get Q suffix M into L, that is equals to I into S. So in this way we can show that the magnetic dipole moment in case of bar magnet and in case of small current loop, that is same, which is equals to Q suffix M into L and I into S. So in magnetostatics there are two magnetic dipole, that is a bar magnet and a small current loop, and its dipole, magnetic dipole moment, is same.